Hi, I'm Abbie Kearse with an MTV News Brief. Alanis Morissette's new home video, Jagged Little Pill Live, hit stores Tuesday, and it documents her 18-month worldwide tour, and it has portions of two new songs, Can't Not and No Pressure Over Cappuccino, which are only heard as background music. Aware of this, we asked Morissette recently when she'll begin recording her next album.
No pressure, you know. It'll happen when it's supposed to happen, and I'm very inspired right now, so I'm not worried.
So far, no recording date is set yet, but we'll keep you posted. That's the news for now. More news at 10 to the hour every hour right here on MTV.
Somebody's sleeping in my bed.
So we're in Druid Hill Park, Baltimore, your hometown. I assume this is where you guys got the name.
Yeah, by Georgia. Good answer. Good answer.
So what is it like here? I mean, growing up in Baltimore, is it quiet? It seems quiet at this
No,
store.
Every day you wake up to chick,
chick, chick, chick, chick,
chick, chick,
chick, chick, chick,
We've been kind of led to this location without much information. So I'm curious, what is the video going to look like? And also tell me about the song a little bit.
Well, basically, this particular song is Sean Combs' own personal tribute to Notorious B.I.G., who's obviously a good friend and also a business partner somewhat. And basically, what the look and the feel of the video is exactly kind of a visual interpretation of how Mr. Combs feels at the present time.
For the Biggie Smalls tribute song, Sean Puffy Combs says he found inspiration in the 80s hit single For the Police, Every Breath You Take.
It was like 2 weeks after the death of Biggie. I was just, you know, watching MTV, just being in the house, and that song came on, and it just made me feel a certain way.
In the world of rap music, especially today, that when you sample a song, you have to get clearance for it. So did you approach Sting and
yes.
ask him for the song?
Yes, Sting. He let us use the song, A&M Records. Thank goodness, let us use the song. They felt where we was coming from. Sting got a lot of soul, though, you know what I'm saying? Sting's a different type of individual.
He's got a little funk in there.
Yeah, if you listen to all his stuff, he got a lot of soul. And if you got soul, then you understand hip-hop.
I think right when Vince got came back, you know, there was 5 years there, we were listening to somebody else's voice to John's, and when, as soon as we were in the studio, I remember, like, you know, just putting the headphones on, sitting behind the drums, and Vince got on the mic and started singing. It's like, whoa, this is, you know, Crew.
While Motley Crue's performance tonight contains mostly material from their new album, Generation Swine, we did get to talk to them a little bit about their 80s video heyday.
I do remember Mick being extremely drunk during the shooting of this.
Yeah, he kept sneaking. He had hidden a bottle of vodka, I think, in the production
office. Pouring in his Coke can.
That's right.
I was just drinking a Coke.
It's because I was older than you guys. I could drink. You couldn't.
All of our acting debuts.
I know. I would never forget. He's like, okay, walk over here and stand and look to the left.
Okay, you guys, surround her. Push her up against the spikes and let her have it.
And now act like you're surprised.
No way.
Make some noise, bastard!
We wanted to shock people. We wanted to wake people up. It was Kaja Goo Goo and, you know, the Knack.
The Knack.
And we were bored.
Basically, we were alternative.
There's always an alternative to what's popular. We're kind of the alternative again, aren't we?
Yeah.